Come on, put your hand together. Let's give God a praise. Come on, stand up on your feet. Let's give God some glory in his house. He blessed us on this morning, but the best is yet to come. I know that something good is going to happen on tonight. Come on, give him some praise. Don't you hold back tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We come to lift him up on tonight. We come to give him some glory on tonight. Look down your road and tell somebody, this road is going to praise God tonight. Don't hold up my blessing. Don't hold up my miracle. Hallelujah. 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 We thank God for Pastor Hale, Sister Hale. Amen. And New Life family, amen, for being here with us all tonight. Amen. I didn't think we was going to get out of here this morning. Amen. The Holy Ghost fell in this place. Amen. Hallelujah. And I know he's going to do the same thing again on tonight. Amen. So we come expecting it on tonight. So you got to come expecting something. If you expecting something, you will get something. So we come expecting something on tonight. Hallelujah. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Father God, we thank you for what you did on this morning. God, we know that you're going to bless us again on tonight. I pray right now, God, that the word that you have for Pastor Hale, God, let it come straight from the press of heaven. Let it come with the anointing. Let it come with power. Touch somebody. Heal somebody. Set somebody free. In the mighty name of Jesus, have your way in this house tonight. Oh, God, have your way, God. Somebody needs a word on tonight. Somebody needs a healing on tonight. Somebody needs a blessing on tonight. In the name of Jesus. So we look for you, God, to do the exceedingly abundant above all that we can even ask or think. Open up the floodgates of heaven. Pour out a blessing, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we'll forever give you the glory, the honor, and the praise in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. Saints, let's have church.
Yeah. just lift your hands and begin to speak to the Lord? Could you just lift your hands all over this place and begin to speak to the Lord? Begin to talk to him. Begin to praise him out of your own mouth, out of your own lips. Can you just begin to tell him how much he means to you? Can you begin to thank him? The Bible said we are to enter his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Hallelujah. He's wonderful. He's wonderful. He's mighty. He's my healer. He's my deliverer. He's my way maker. He's my strength. He's the lily in the valley, the bright of the morning star. He is my shield and my buckler. He is the glory and the lifter of my head. Oh, Jesus. We love you, Lord. saints. Let's give the Lord a praise in this place. Hallelujah. How many of y'all know he's Lord of all? Hallelujah, Jesus. We love you in this place, dear God. Amen. Well, we welcome all of you here. We're so, again, so glad to have Elder Hale here with us. Amen. And his wonderful wife, Missionary Lori Hale. All the saints of God from Powerful New Life, Church of God in Christ, we're so glad to have you all as well. Amen. Praise God. If you're here with Powerful New Life, could you just raise your hand and let us see you? Just let us see you. Amen. Amen. If you're a first-time visitor in this place, could you just raise your hand so we can acknowledge you as well? Amen. Amen. Glad to have you as well. Amen. It is a wonderful night to be in the house of God. And just to be able to fellowship again is such a wonderful thing. And to be able to be in this place, we're expecting great things from the Lord. Amen. Before we do that, we have to take up an offering. Amen. Amen. I can't wait till after he's done preaching, because we may not be able to get to take up an offering. Amen. And I want you to know that this dear brother never comes asking for anything. But the Bible says that you do not bridle the ox that treads out the corn. And a workman is definitely worthy of his hire. And so we want to bless this man of God. And some of y'all may be saying, well, I will. I just want to hear him preach first. I promise you will not be disappointed, all right? But we don't buy tickets around here, all right? This is not a show. But we want to be a blessing to this wonderful man of God. And I'm going to ask you to dig real deep. Amen. And Sister Chandra, I want to count on this. I want to count on this before he's done preaching, because if we didn't bless him good enough, I may have to come back to you and say, you know what? Amen. You need to dig a little deeper, praise the name of the Lord. Because I believe in blessing men of God. This is not easy. This is not an easy line of work to be in. It is the best thing you can ever do, but at the same time, it's not easy. Amen. And we want to make sure that when he leaves this place, not only has he left a blessing, but we are able to give him a blessing. And so I have given you plenty of time. You say, I don't have any cash on me. Can I write a check? You can write a check. Just write it to New Destiny. And we will make sure that that check turns into cash, and we'll give him the cash. And so if you do not have cash with you, you're welcome to write a check. Those of you that are giving tithes in here, you can put that in an envelope, because anything that is not in an envelope is going to go to this man of God. And we're going to bless him abundantly for it, because we believe that God calls men. One organization that I had an uncle that was part of, he said they would tell him, well, God will keep him humble and we'll keep him hungry. Well, we're not going to keep him hungry around here. We want to feed him real good, because he's going to feed us real good. I did tell Missionary Hale that I was going to have her sing something, so she jetted out here real fast, but she's still not going to get by with it. Amen. Amen. I can't let her go out of here without singing something. And so we're going to have her do that. But I've given you time now. You've been able to dig deep in your pockets, deep, deep in your pockets. And so we're going to stand our feet one more time. We're going to ask the Lord to bless this offering. Here at New Destiny, we do not come take your offering. We don't believe in taking people's offering. We do believe in you giving in the offering. So our usher will come down in the front and he'll have the offering pans. So please just give as the Lord has blessed you, and then do it quickly and expediently, and make your way back to your seat if you would, so that others behind you can give as well. But Lord, we thank you so much for the honor and the opportunity we have to be here. We thank you, God, for this night. We thank you for this moment. We thank you, God, for this fellowship. We thank you, God, for the night to be able to come together and worship God together and hear from the Word of God together. Now we pray, Lord, that you will touch this offering. Bless the hand that is going to give it tonight. Bless them abundantly, God. as you watch over your word to perform it concerning each one of them, because you said if we give, you would give back to us, Lord, pressed down, shaken together in good measure, God, you would cause men to pour into our bosom. Now, Lord God, have your way for the rest of this service. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost reign on this place, God. Let somebody come running tonight saying, what must I do to be saved, God? We believe, God, that people are going to get filled with the Holy Ghost tonight, that bodies are going to be healed, God, that minds are going to be delivered, God, that demonic oppression and demonic possession has to go tonight in the name of Jesus, as the anointing of your power will be made manifest, as you reveal your arm in the congregation of these your saints and show yourself strong to us, oh God. So, Lord, we thank you in advance for what you're getting ready to do. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Come on, brother, let's get this offering. Praise God.
Oh,
may not mean nothing to some of y'all, but I'm telling you, saints of God, that is our hope. That is our hope. He said, if I go away, I'm coming again. I'm bound for the kingdom, brother. Woo! Bound for it. Bound for it. Praise God. Amen. All right, at this time, I'm going to ask Jahel to come up. Just bless us in a song, please, 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 please. It's been so long since I've heard her sing. She's such a blessing. Amen. Wonderful woman of God. Amen. Come, sister.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. I need the continue rather to have your way. God bless this pastor. God bless this pastor's wife, Lady Manning, God. Lord, bless this church, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, you know the needs, God. Oh, Father, we give you praise. We thank you for this beautiful edifice, God. You did it, God. Oh, God, when nothing else could help. Thank you, Jesus. You did it, God. Thank you, Jesus. You did it, God, because your man and your woman stood on your promises. And we thank you for it, God. Thank you for this family. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for Elder Hale coming on tonight. We pray, God, that you will stand up in him and that you will send the word with power and authority. Oh, God, even though all of us is going through different things, God, we know that this word is going to be tailor-made. Oh, it's just going to be just for us. Oh, thank you. It's going to be a fit message. Hallelujah. And we thank you, God. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord. And I lift my voice to worship you, oh, my soul rejoices. Take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, my soul rejoices. Take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound here, your ears. And Lord, you are the King of Kings. And Lord, you who are the King of Kings, and you're the source of my supply. Yes, you are. And you're the apple of my eye. And that's why I praise you. That's why I praise you. Oh, that's why I praise you. Not because I'm good, God, but because of who you are. Put your hands together and give God a great big praise. Come on, give him your best praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, clap your hands, all you people. Shout unto the Lord with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah, Jesus. Woo! Oh, Lord. My goodness. Praise God. God, praise God. Woo! Hallelujah. Without any further delay, I want to bring to this pulpit, amen, my friend for now about 20 years, known each other a long time now, and we've ministered together on many, 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 many occasions, and it is my privilege, it is our blessing, and it is our honor to bring to this pulpit Elder Hugh Allen Hale. Brother, preach the word.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's give God praise for this man of God, Pastor Jared Manning. Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord praise for his lovely wife. Amen. And their beautiful family. I mean the whole family. Mom, dad, everybody. Cause we know y'all like that. You all are our extended family. And man, I'm excited to be back in fellowship with my extended families. It's like a family reunion. It's just a great ministry, and we love you. And we're so excited about this beautiful church. We had this is our first time to be able to see. It's beautiful. And this is the Lord's doing. And it's marvelous. Marvelous in our eyes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This season, the giant in the Lord, Elder Kevin Beattie, my friend. God bless you. It's always a blessing to see you and be around you. And I thank God I see some of my friends I've known for a whole bunch of years. Thank God for Brother Chad and Sister Stephanie Lane. Yeah, they some of our family as well. Thank you, Jesus. And they raised some money when they was Power of a New Life to send us on our first vacation. Amen. I had never been to the beach before. Amen. Just fine people. Amen. Fine people of the Lord. Thank God for my sweet tulip on the meadow's grass. My jewel. My diadem. My Mayflower. My sweet thing. We're coming up on 35 years. I give God praise for it. Give God praise. I do praise God for some of the saints from Powerful A New Life. Y'all see, we love y'all New Destiny. Amen. Amen. When the word got out, we all got excited. Amen. Amen. Just a beautiful fellowship. And to Jesus, the presence of God is so rich. Hallelujah. In his presence is a fullness of joy. At his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. He said, Lord, you're going to show me the path of life. Amen. That's what the psalmist said. You're going to show me the path of life. And God says, okay, the path of life is in my presence. Hallelujah. 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 Psalm 16:11, they said, let us know that the path of life is in his presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise takes you there. Worship takes you there. Psalm 22 said he inhabits the praises of Israel. He lives in your praises. He takes up residence in your praises. He reclines in your praises. He rests, relaxes on you in your praise and worship. Hallelujah. 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 See, every time you shout hallelujah, there he is. Every time you say thank you, Jesus, there he is. Every time you say glory to God, there he is. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless all these men of God, women of God, elders, deacons. Thank you so much. Praise God. We love and appreciate you. Amen. From the Word of God, we're going to go to Genesis chapter 4. For our Old Testament, Old Covenant reading. Genesis chapter 4, verses 10 through 12. Genesis chapter 4, verses 10 through 12. Amen. New Testament reading, text will be from the Hall of Faith. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 4. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 4. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you. Thank you for those that are standing in reverence to the word of the Lord. Genesis chapter 4, verses 10 through 12. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you and praise you for the word. God, send the word with the demonstration of the Holy Ghost, with power. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, anoint our ears to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church in this hour. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, help us not to just be hearers only, but be doers of your word, imitators of your word. God, in the name of Jesus, help us to be walking epistles, read of men every day. Let that be true. Oh God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Lord, you are my strength. Oh God, you are my redeemer. In the name of Jesus, amen. And he said, what hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground. And now art thou cursed from the earth, which hath opened her mouth to receive thy brother's blood from thy hand. When thou tillest the ground, it shall not henceforth yield unto thee her strength. A fugitive and a vagabond shalt thou be in the earth. Hebrews chapter 11. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I take one verse from Hebrews 11, and that will be verse 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained a witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts. And by it, he being dead, yet speaketh. Just want to use for thought the blood. You may be seated in the presence of God. The blood. The law tells us in Leviticus 17 and 11 that the life of all flesh is in the blood. Amen. The blood is so important that whenever you go to get a diagnosis from the doctor, if he wants to know what's going on the inside, if he wants to know in detail what's happening on the inside, he can't really make a proper prognosis or diagnosis without drawing your blood. Because he knows whatever is contaminating you, whatever is causing the problem, he's going to get what he needs to help treat you from the blood. The blood is extremely important. I'm talking naturally speaking now, because again, the life is in the blood. When the blood leaves, your life leaves. Am I right about that? The blood in your body, it carries oxygen. It carries breath in it. Hallelujah. Every vital organ has to be touched, saturated by the blood. Your lungs can't function properly without the blood. Your brain cannot function properly without the blood. Your kidneys cannot function properly without the blood. Your liver is of no use without the blood. Your heart, which is the center of your body, has to pump the blood through the body. Hallelujah. It's the blood. God knew this. Amen. When he created Adam and Eve, he knew beforehand, amen, the power, the significance of the blood. The Bible says that he was slain from the foundation. I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit. I got to stay with the natural and I get to the spiritual. But he was slain from the foundation of the world. In other words, he is, amen, and was, and he is to come. He is eternal. He is everlasting from everlasting. He's the Alpha and the Omega. Amen. He's the beginning and the end. He's the Ancient of Days. He's, hallelujah, amen. He's eternal. Praise God. So he knows the end from the beginning and the beginning from the end. Hallelujah. Amen. So he was slain from the foundation because he knows how awesome and how significant the blood is. Amen. It was so significant that the Lord himself, when man fell, amen, in the sin, you all know, in the garden, that the man was found naked, saw himself as being uncovered. When he fell into sin, he took knowledge then that he didn't have nothing on his body. When really, before the sin, it didn't matter. Because he was innocent. So the blood declares innocence and it declares guilt. Somebody say amen. When you murder, you spill out, amen, the blood, the life, the very essence of the body, and then you're guilty because you shed innocent blood. So then you're called a blood guilty. Somebody say amen. Guilt comes. Guilt comes because the blood is life. Do I have a witness here? See, and so you got to understand how awesome the blood is. Now, as we look here, we see that the life of the body, naturally speaking, is in the blood. Amen? We also understand, we must understand that DNA is the blood. It carries the DNA. Amen. So it comes through the seed. Amen. So praise God for the seed. Thank God for the seed. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 After God created man from the dust of the earth, hallelujah, are you hearing what I'm saying? Put him to sleep and took a rib out and built a woman. Praise God. He set up seed time. He set up DNA. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When Adam and Eve begin to procreate, amen, it come from a seed. Amen, they carried the blood. And so now you have Adam and you have Eve, all right, producing seed from blood. Hallelujah. And then you got the first children, Cain and Abel. Am I right? So now you have a family set up now. And so now it's the blood. Praise God. Now they're starting to travel through the line. Somebody give God some praise. Hallelujah. They're starting to travel through the line to bring inheritance, to carry traits from one generation to the next generation. Amen. I'm talking about the blood. Glory to God. Now because of the blood, hallelujah, there is a kindred. Thank you, Jesus, from the seed. Hallelujah. Cain and Abel are brothers now because of blood. Somebody say amen. I said they're brothers now because of blood. Hallelujah. And here's where I'm going with this. Hallelujah. It's the confusion of the devil. Amen. To make it look as if the blood is mixed. To make it look as if there's something different. Hallelujah. Because of skin tone. Hallelujah. In Acts chapter 17. Amen. 24 through 26. It lets us know we're made by one blood. Hallelujah. Every one of us is made by one blood. Everybody in here. If you're black, if you're white, that's what man calls us. If you're brown, if you're yellow, if you're red, that's what man calls us. Everybody in here come from the same blood. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. The Bible says one blood. So it doesn't matter. See, God, I believe he has a sense of humor because in all this confusion that the devil is trying to start, we're getting more and more mixed up. The more they try to proclaim supremacy, the more they try to proclaim supreme, the more God allows things to mix up. Why? Because we all are the same. Somebody say amen. God said, the Lord says, what I'm going to do, I'm going to let everybody know, hallelujah, that they ain't no big eyes and no little U's. I'm going to show them that it ain't nobody better than nobody else. I'm going to show them that I am no other respecter of persons. So I'm going to allow the Savior of the whole world to come down through 42 generations. I'm going to allow him to travel. Oh, bless the Lord. Even though the nation of Israel is his chosen one to send our Savior through, the Lord says, I'm going to travel with my seed. I'm going to carry the seed of the word. I'm going to carry the blood. Hallelujah. And the bloodline down through Rahab, the harlot. I'm going to let that line, that scarlet thread, that scarlet rope, hallelujah, it represents, oh my God, the bloodline. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to let them know, praise God, I'm going to send my Savior through, hallelujah, a prostitute, bloodline, just to let everybody know, hallelujah, there ain't nobody God but God. Let everybody know, hallelujah, that I have the last word, and I have the last say. Hallelujah. Y'all know the Bible. Somebody say amen. Ruth was Moabitess. Hallelujah. She was not of the nation of Israel. Am I right about it? But here here comes Jesus traveling and taking his seed and his blood through that line to, my God, bring in, hallelujah, even in the Old Testament, the Gentiles. Somebody, I feel like running through a troop, my God. My God, I feel like leaping over a wall. Hallelujah. We got all this confusion. We got all this, my God, anger. We got all this hatred. Hallelujah. And we carry the same blood. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody ought to give God praise because you're carrying the same blood. There's a family inheritance. Whether you want to admit it or not, I don't know. I think everybody in here might want to admit it. Hallelujah. But we all got the same blood. You come from Adam, and I come from Adam. You came from Eve, and I came from Eve. Hallelujah. But you got demon spirits that will attack the body, that will try to attack the inheritance, that will try to attack the DNA, that will try and attack the seed, that would try to attack the life. Somebody say amen. It didn't just start. Am I right about it? But the spirit of murder, hallelujah, started with Cain. Do I have a witness here? Hallelujah. But oh, you can't stop the blood. Hallelujah. When Cain killed his brother Abel, hallelujah, it was the blood that testified. Hallelujah. The very light that was built out on the ground by Cain. Abel's blood began to preach. Abel's blood began to preach and testify. Hallelujah. I don't care what the devil tries to do. I don't care how much hatred that he has. I don't care how much he tries to attack different races. When there's only one human race. Hallelujah. The blood cannot be stopped. The blood cannot be denied. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. And what I love about the blood, hallelujah, you can tell who's kin to who. I recently took a picture and put it on social media of our youngest son. We had to do that with him because I can't catch him. I put it on social media. I said, well, I guess I mean, we'd been taking advantage of this opportunity to start taking pictures. We don't know when we can see him again because he's in now. But then, when you know, I was 6'4". He was 6'2". And when I looked at the picture, now I'm 6'2", and he's 6'4". He getting taller, I'm shrinking. But when you look at him and look at me, you can tell he's my son. And see, what am I saying? Hallelujah. The blood is your identity. You're going to look like your relative. Somebody say amen. I said, you're going to look like your relative. I say you're going to look like your relative. Hallelujah. Whenever Peter was trying to lie, he said, oh, you're a Galilean. You're one of them. See what I'm saying? What am I saying? You're going to look like your DNA. You're going to look like your brother. Now look at that beautiful. Oh, my, she's beautiful. Look at my beautiful baby girl. Huh? And I just got a handsome husband right there. Look on the other side and look. Can you tell it? She looked like her mama. Why? Somebody said because of the blood. See, what you need to understand is the blood is so rich. The blood is so powerful. It has always amazed me how you can skip generations and still look just like Somebody say amen. You could go back to your great, 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 greats and be looking just like them. It never loses. Y'all know where I'm going with that. It never loses its power. It never loses its strength. Glory to God. So the blood is life. The blood is seed. The blood is DNA. The blood is family inheritance. The blood, hallelujah, glory to God, carries life to the body. But another thing the blood does, hallelujah, when it pumps through the body, it only not only carries oxygen, but it carries carbon dioxide away from the vital organs all at the same time. It's carrying cell building materials to the vitals and carrying contaminants away from the vitals all at the same time. Somebody ought to give God praise for the blood. Somebody ought to give God praise for the blood. Oh, the blood. Hallelujah. That gives me strength from day to day. It will never, never, never lose. Never lose its power. Hallelujah. Hey. So we find out that the blood is a cleansing agent. Even in the natural. I ain't got to the spiritual yet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It washes away contaminants and poisons that tries to contaminate your body. And see, what I love about the blood, it does the same thing spiritually. That's why the old saints, I grew up around the old school. Whenever mama and daddy and elders, hallelujah, and old mothers got serious about warfare. Yeah, when they prayed and fasted, yeah, they really wanted the devil, hallelujah, to lose his hold. Do I have a witness out? They began to plead the blood. Oh, the Holy Ghost had them plead the blood. I'm telling you, when you really want to get serious, when the devil's trying to steal, when he's trying to destroy and kill, hallelujah, if you, my God, shift your prayer language, hallelujah, and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, and when you finally come into your native tongue, when you finally come to English, you plead the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood, the blood of Jesus. Oh my God. Now y'all see why the devil is trying to spill innocent blood. Oh my God. Spill innocent blood. Now y'all see why the devil, who knows he has a short time, he wants to bring confusion in the body, in the church, in society. He got a murdering demon. Somebody say amen. Whether you believe it or not, it's been exposed. Whether you believe it or not, it's been shown. You may not feel like anything's been exposed, but it's been shown. Hallelujah. And God will allow things to be shown if you're deep enough spiritually to understand. Hallelujah. This is all about the blood. This is all about territory. This is all about race. Hiya, glory. Somebody say amen. But I'm so glad to know, hallelujah, as I close my message, praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The blood, hallelujah, spiritually now. Jesus said, what I'm going to do, hallelujah, I'm going to take up Abel's testimony. Hallelujah. When Abel was telling on his brother. Hallelujah. Ooh, glory to God. I said when he was telling on his brother, after he'd already been killed, and his blood began to testify and tell on Cain. Hallelujah. The Lord said, I heard. What brought division? Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Oh, bless his name. I'm going to use what brought hatred, malice, murder, killing, evil. I'm going to turn it around. Hallelujah. And I'm going to shed my blood, even for Cain's unrighteous soul. Somebody say amen. And I'm going to show him that the blood that he's spilled out, I'm going to take his place. And I'm going to bring innocence back to the blood. Hallelujah. Cain brought guilt to the blood. Can I get a witness in this place? But Jesus brought innocence back to the blood. And what you need to do, you need to praise him like you lost your mind, because the blood still works. The blood, I said the blood is just as rich, just as powerful right now as it was over 2,000 years ago. Somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. And here's where God is going as he speaks this word to you today. He said the very blood that brought confusion, I'm going to use it to bring reconciliation. Hallelujah. I'm going to come to you to reconcile us back to God. I'm going to come to you to bring the ministry of love where there was hate, to bring the ministry of caring when it was nobody caring, to bring the ministry of reconciliation. And all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and have given to us the ministry of reconciliation. See, the ministry that he's given us is not the ministry of division. It's not the ministry of who has the best church. It's not the ministry of who has the word and who don't have it. It's not the ministry, somebody say amen, hallelujah, of drawing people to us. It's not about that. Hallelujah. It's not the ministry of who has the best denomination, whether you enter denomination, whether you're non-denominational, whether you are denominational, it really don't matter, because it's not really about that. Hallelujah. Y'all gonna have to pray for me. Are y'all praying for me? Oh, glory to God. I'm not gonna fight with you, even over water baptism. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord, because Jesus, he is the Father. Jesus, he is the Son. Jesus, he is the Holy Ghost. It's time to quit splitting hairs and put down and settle our differences here. It's time to get back to the blood, the ministry of reconciliation, to wit that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and had committed unto us the word of reconciliation. If you want a word deep and revelant, it's time to get back to the word of reconciliation. Somebody help me say amen. Glory to God. It's really plain and simple. Jesus was wounded for my transgressions. Jesus was wounded for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and with his stripes I am healed. We all like sheep have gone astray, every man his own way, but he laid upon himself the iniquities of, somebody say, the blood of us all. Somebody shout the blood. Somebody shout the blood. Somebody shout the blood. And I'm telling you, when we get back together, hallelujah, in one, the Holy Ghost revival, hallelujah, will hit us, hallelujah, my God, like it did at Pentecost, where they was all in one place, with one accord, and suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. Hallelujah. And it filled the house that they were sitting. Oh, bless his name. And tongues of fire came and sat down on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. Say yes, Lord. And why, my God, you see Acts now. You see Peter now, the pillar of the church. He jumped up and preached. Hallelujah. This is that that was spoken of by the prophet Joel. Say yes, Lord. These are not drunk with new wine as you suppose. Hallelujah. Hey, but this is the Holy Ghost. And see, the blood brought the Holy Ghost on the scene. If the blood hadn't been shed on Calvary's cross, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost could not have been brought on the scene to even start the church, to even start an apostolic anointing, to even start an apostolic church. It all started with the blood. Say yeah, say yeah. The blood, I say the blood of Jesus defeats sickness and death. Somebody say amen. It's time to apply the blood. If you're sick in here tonight, you won't have to leave here like you came because of the blood. The blood. Oh, the blood. And listen, let me tell you, the blood is the great, he is the great denominator. The blood levels the field. See, see, Israel, amen, had that royal blood, huh? But see, what's awesome about the blood, amen, we ought to praise God, because God winked at their ignorance. And the blood has ability to adopt. Somebody say amen. See, God took Paul up in the third heaven and gave him all kinds of revelation. Amen. He wrote a letter to one of the churches. And said, we've been adopted in. Remember, I told you, Rahab is a glimpse of us in the Old Testament. Amen. So now, us now, people, yeah, that was not a people. Amen. Told that to the Roman church, that you wasn't even a people. Amen. Hosea said, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. See, you were not even a people. Thank you, Jesus. But are you glad that the blood has the power to adopt us? See? Amen. Amen. Brother, that ought to be your most prized possession, my son-in-law, and it is, as far as a son. Amen? Because it's something special, amen, about the adoption. Hallelujah. Hey, I said it's something special about the adoption. It was so special. God gave Paul revelations and let me the preacher of the Gentiles. I know I'm Israelite. I'm Israelite through and through. I was circumcised the 8th day. The stock of I know all that. Amen. I'm a Hebrew of Hebrews. Law blameless. Pharisee of a Pharisee. Ain't that right? But I want to go to those people that's not a people. Send me to them. Send me to the ones that's been cast aside. Send me to the ones that nobody else think about or care about. Send me to the ones that's been rejected and despised. Because just like them. Jesus says, I was despised and rejected. And I promise you, as I close now, hallelujah, was awesome to me. Hallelujah, you scholars, you probably already know this. Hallelujah, but oh, praise God. Hallelujah. I'm going to go ahead. Hallelujah. Amen. And praise him. Don't y'all bust my bubble. I'm going to go ahead and praise him. Hallelujah. If you already knew it, brother, I know you was going to act like you didn't know it. Hallelujah. I found out in studying the blood. When I studied the blood, I found out that reconciliation and atonement has the same meaning. Atonement, cover, purge, forgive. Cleanse, pacify, pardon. Get this. Be merciful. As I studied reconciliation, it said cover, purge, forgive, cleanse, pacify, pardon, be merciful. Reconciliation. Now do y'all see what kind of ministry we're supposed to have? Then why are we fighting and splitting hairs over doctrine, baptisms? Why are we fighting? Splitting hairs over denominations? Why are we fighting? Splitting hairs over who's less and who's more? When we all come together, there's only one denominator that brings us all together, and it's the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The blood grafted me in. The blood adopted me in. The blood, when I was a mess in the middle of a mess, wasn't fit to live, wasn't ready to die, but the Lord shed his blood. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What we're going to do, we're going to get together. The Holy Ghost is putting his people together, and we're getting together now with the ministry of one blood, the ministry of reconciliation. Get excited. The church is being set up by God. My God, woo, to be one blood. Hallelujah. One body, one faith, one baptism, one blood. The blood of Jesus has took over. Amen. I said the blood of Jesus has took over. Amen. I say the blood of Christ has took over. The blood of Jesus has took over. The blood of Jesus has took over. The blood of Jesus has took over. Amen. The fight is fixed. The battle's already been won. Why? Because the blood has already been shed. And see, here's what I want to do on this last quote, Revelations 12 and 11. In Revelation, when you read it, it's when you study it, it's eternal. Amen. It's eternal. We'll talk about that later. But notice, he said, and there was a war in heaven, Revelation 12, y'all know that. Lucifer was kicked out. He thought it was bad. Michael kicked him out. All right. Then the 11th verse says, and they overcame the devil. That old dragon. Satan. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. And the word of their testimony. Cain got overcame by Abel's blood and his testimony. It was started again through his son Seth. Amen. A new beginning started with Seth, Abel's son. And what am I saying? That Abel's blood, you got types and shadows of Christ all throughout the Old Testament. Abel's bloodshed is a type and shadow of Christ's bloodshed. You ought to praise God for the blood. And what I'm telling y'all right now, all we got to do is preach Jesus and Him crucified. Amen. The full baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen. 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 That baptism in water and a baptism in the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. The baptism of the Holy Ghost after the water and the baptism of the Holy Ghost even before the water. But make sure you go to the water. Because Cornelius and his household were baptized in the Holy Ghost before they went. But after they got the Holy Ghost, they go get in the water. If we preach this and stay pure with it and not get caught up in all this circus, shenanigan, crazy stuff that's going on in the world, all this division and hate and strife, it feels good to your flesh, but your flesh must be crucified. So the blood can prevail. Y'all didn't get that, did you? Y'all didn't get that. See, when you're having fun arguing on social media, hallelujah, about all this political mess, hallelujah, it's your flesh being pacified and satisfied. You need to go to the cross and be crucified. And when you are crucified, the blood song we used to come sing, God don't need no matches. He fired by himself. The blood don't need no help. It's the blood all by itself. Hallelujah. Man. Somebody shout the blood. Hallelujah. I remember I'm going to pray for some people. God's going to heal some bodies tonight. I remember my wife going through some things. We was living in Morristown at the time. She was going through some things. And the Lord began to minister to her. Amen. She told me this. I don't know if she remembers it or not. He ministered to her about the blood. And it's a song. Of course, she's a songbird. The blood that flows to the lowest valley. The blood that reaches to the highest mountain. Am I right, my brother? The blood that never loses power. Hallelujah. The blood that gives me strength from day to day. Thank God for the blood. Will you rest on your feet? I'm going to pray. Pastor, thank you for this opening up your pulpit and allowing us to come in to share with you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to your holy name, Jesus. With the stripes of Jesus, by the blood, healing is not just for the physical body. It's for the emotional mind as well. It's for the psyche. Yes. Amen. The blood of Jesus. It's time to plead and apply the blood over your minds. But just know that the blood of Jesus will heal your body. Anybody having hip back pain, come. I'm going to pray for you. Anybody that's facing some surgeries, come. We're going to pray for you. Anybody that's been told by the doctors who practice, have been given a report that was not so good. I ask you to come. I'm going to pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I trust that everybody in here is saved. I trust that everybody in here, if you're not, the blood was shed for your salvation. See, the atonement is one of the most powerful things. And so it's all kinds of powerful. I can't really categorize it. But the atonement, the covering, hallelujah, of the blood is so awesome. Thank you, Jesus. The blood cleanses us. And then covers us all at the same time. with protection. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And because of the blood is constantly testifying against the accuser. Constantly doing it. He ever lives to do it. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Hebrews that Jesus saves to the uttermost. And he ever lives forever just to make intercession for us. It's because of the blood. The blood still speaks. It never stops speaking. Never stops testifying. Never stops fighting for you. Never stops beating away demons and imps that's coming against the mind. The blood has already driven away witchcraft demons. Spirits of witches and warlocks. When you start applying the blood of Jesus, they can't stay around. They can't stay around. Every hex, every potion and every spell that's been trying to be pronounced over you has been driven back to sender by the blood of Christ. Every curse that's tried to visit the second and third, fourth generation has been destroyed and driven away by the blood. By the blood. Galatians 3:13 says, curses any man that hangs on the tree. What he done, he took every curse. Hey, when you're covered by the blood, witches cannot even put no potion on. They can't even put no black magic on you. They can't, because you're covered by the blood of Jesus. But you got to learn to apply the blood. You got to learn to apply it. Apply it against those demons. Apply it against spirits of control and witchcraft. Apply the blood of Jesus against them. Spirit of confusion is a spirit of witchcraft. There's a spirit of witchcraft released out in the air. The blood of Jesus. Has driven it back. Lift your hands and tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Brother, I don't know how y'all do it. Amen. Anyone? Thank you, Jesus. I don't want to. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we praise you. Lord, we give you glory.
Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. We're going to pray over my grandson right now that has not yet been born, that God will keep and heal and strengthen. Seats for a moment. It's the blood, brother. Amen. How many of y'all have been honored to be in the house of God tonight? I don't ever take this for granted, ever. This is the greatest honor that a man can experience, is to be in the presence of God. Amen. I just want to extend our warmest and deepest love. Amen. To Elder Hell, to Missionary Hell, and to all the saints of God, a powerful new life. We love you. God bless you. Amen. 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 You know, the spirit that is in this world is threatened by this atmosphere. The spirit that is in this world is threatened by what's happening. You know, some of you may have never, ever traveled outside of the United States, and so we do see the racial conflict in the United States, and it's a big deal. But if you go to Africa, when I was in Africa, they have what's called tribalism. And it's just the shape of somebody's chin or their nose, and they can tell this is this tribe, and we're better than that tribe. And they slaughter each other, they kill each other. You go into India, you have the caste system, which is really classism. And depending on what family you're born to, you will either be served or you will be the servant. This has been going on for generations. And no matter how many great leaders have risen up, like Dr. King, in this country to try to fix the issue, or Nelson Mandela in South Africa, no matter how many great leaders have risen up in this world, this world just degenerates and goes back to its original state. Because men are always going to hate men. It's never, ever going to stop until Jesus comes. It's the truth. But, our citizenship is not in this world. Our citizenship is in heaven. And we're looking for the Savior. And so they can do whatever they want outside these doors. We'll never fix that. But the church has answered the problem. So I want to invite you, if you're tired of racism and tribalism and classism, come into the church.
into the church, because God has made of all nations one blood through Jesus Christ. We got it.
The answer is in the church. And the reason why God will never permit the answer to be in the world is because he wants people to come to the church. So let's show love in the church. Let's show brotherhood in the church. Let's show kindness in the church. Amen. Let's be unified in the church. Let the world have their conversation. Our conversation is in heaven. Let them have their conversation. When I come in here, come on, if you can't see skin color, then you must be colorblind. I think that's ridiculous. I don't see color. Well, of course you do. But what we do see is we see that we're all covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. And we've all been made partakers into one family by one blood, by one spirit. And so there's neither Jew nor Gentile. There's neither bond nor free. There's neither Greek nor barbarian. But we are all the children of the Most High God. Glory to God. And so this is who we are. And if we will be this, listen, there are people in the world that are getting sick of this conversation. Because now for centuries, it has been discussed without answer. But you come in here tonight. In this church, as Brother Hell said, you will see white, black, Hispanic. Come on. You'll see it in this church. Because we don't permit the garbage of the world to come into this church. We're going to be children of God. And we're going to love each other with a pure heart fervently. And a love that ain't nothing fake about this love. Because the Holy Ghost has shed abroad in our hearts the love of God. That this is the realest love you will find on planet Earth. Yes, sir. Glory to God. You're my brother whether you like it or not. You're my sister whether you like it or not. Because we got one Father and one Mother. And New Jerusalem, which is above being free, is the mother of us all. Take that, devil. Take that, spirit of the world. You ain't coming in here. We're the children of the Most High God. And we're going to love each other till Jesus. Just the way it is. Look at your neighbor, tell him it's just the way it is. It's just the way it is. You're going to love me whether you like it or not. Hallelujah. That's just the way it is. Amen. We're going to get coffee together whether you like it or not. That's just the way it is. We're going to come into each other's home and eat together, and I don't even care if you like it, because that's just the way it is. You may not like me, but I guarantee you, if you will follow, if you will stick around long enough, you will love me. God's going to work all this out. But he's going to work it out in the church. He's going to work it out right here in the church. Amen. Praise God. He's going to work it out right here in the church. So be my brother. Be my sister. Amen. I will love you whether you like me or not. I will love you whether you love me or not. Amen. Let us show the world that they're as crazy as they think they are. Because when you come in here, we don't have the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. They're crazy. We got it together in here, because the mind that was in Christ Jesus is inside of me. And the Bible said he died not for our sins only, but for the sins of the whole world. He said, other sheep I have, and I must bring them in also. He went to that Samaritan woman because that was his sheep too. He healed that centurion servant because that was his sheep too. Good God. I hope you're hearing what I'm saying. He delivered that Syrophoenician woman's daughter because that was his child. I'm going to say this and we're going to go. That woman came up to him Say, Lord, my daughter is grievously vexed to the devil. And Jesus looks at her and says, hold up, woman. It is not me. He said, I wasn't sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. It is not meet for me to give the children's bread unto the dogs. He wasn't saying that for his benefit. He was talking to everybody else in the room. He didn't look at her as a dog because he created that woman. God in heaven. And she said, but Lord, even the dogs get to eat of the crumbs that fall from the master's table. He looks at all those pious religious people and he said, so great a faith I haven't found in all of Israel. Don't ever discount nobody. Because as long as there's breath in their body, there's hope for their soul. I don't care if it's in Skid Row or solitary confinement. I don't care if it's in the penthouse or corporate America. There's hope. Because if we're not careful, this nation and in the church, we're going to get into classism. And the poor is going to hate the wealthy. And the wealthy is going to hate the poor. We are deteriorating into that right now. See somebody drive up on a nice cart in the church parking lot. Think they're somebody. I bet you they think they're better than me. You don't know what they think. The Bible said a wise man doesn't judge a matter before he hears it. So if you ain't heard them say they're better than you, you don't know what they think. Quit looking at people's station in life and considering what they think, because really the prejudice is in you. The Bible said no man knoweth the heart of man except the spirit of the man that dwelleth in him. The church has got the answer. And we're going to be it. Whether the world likes it or not. Because John saw a number that no man could number. Coming about a great tribulation. Having washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. And where were they from? From every kindred. From every tribe. From every nation. And from every tongue. If you don't like worshiping with people that ain't your specific shade of color, you ain't ready for the kingdom. Because in the kingdom, we all gonna be there. And there ain't gonna be your section and my section. But we're gonna go before the throne of God, all of us. The saints from all the ages. We're gonna go up into the sea of glass. Bow down before the throne of God and say, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, the earth is full of your glory. So we're gonna be that. Because we are called to reconciliation. Yes, sir. We're called to that. We have to do that. We have to do that. And there ain't nothing like the blood of Jesus and the Holy Ghost and the anointed ministry that can get into your spirit and change your entire mind about everything you think. So hold on, children of God. The greatest days of the church are yet ahead of us. Somebody actually believed that. Thank you, brother. I said the greatest days of the church are yet ahead of us. Don't think the church is losing. We're just really getting started all over again. We're getting back up on our feet. We're getting ourselves. We're putting on the whole armor of God. And we got the sword of the Spirit in our hands, which is the Word of God. And I come to serve notice on the enemy tonight. We're coming. We are coming to every neighborhood. We're coming to every people. We're coming to every nation. We're coming to every tongue. We're coming to every tribe. We're so look at your neighbor. Tell him you better get ready. You better get ready. It's coming. And don't get caught. Listen. Don't get caught up in the smoke screen of the political world. Ain't none of that real anyways. None of it's real. None of it. None of it. Well, I voted for so-and-so. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Ain't none of that real. None of it's real. Listen, I told my wife the other day. I said if the 1% or if the 99% could ever get in their head that it is the 1%
that's stirring all the division to keep the 99% divided so that they can have absolute control. If the 99% ever figured out what the 1% were doing, the 1% would actually be in trouble. We're going to get this done because we're called to it. This is our time. And in every generation, God has raised up men and movements that would penetrate the spirit of the age and would draw people out who are in bondage right now to the culture and bring them into the glorious liberty of children of God. He's always had it. And there's always been men of God and women of God that have been willing to stand up on their feet and willing to take the Lord at his word and soldier on. There's no armor on your back. Because retreat is not an option. So let's go forward, saints. Let's accept our calling. I have accepted it in this church. I told the Lord, I'm tired of segregated Sunday. I'm fed up with it. We're going to come together and worship together. And we're going to learn to love one another. Because if we can't do it, Paul said, I hear there are divisions among you. And I believe it because you're carnal. He said you're carnal. If there's division, it's carnality. But saints of God, we must be spiritually minded. And look past the division that is being perpetuated in this world to try to keep us bound. And love one another. Do you know what love unfeigned is? It just means it's not fake. When I tell you I love you, you better know that I love you. There ain't nothing fake about it. I am not a fake person. Anybody that knows me, I will say whatever I feel in my spirit. I am not fake at all. So if I look at you and say, I love you, you better know. Sister Deborah, I love you. And you better know I love you. Come on, somebody. Sister Hell, I love you, and you better know it. I love you, brother, you better know it. When I say I love you, you better know I love you. Brother Justin, you better know I love you. Brother Jonathan, you better know I love you. Because I don't waste that word. That's a powerful word. And I don't love you because I know you. I don't love you because you have money. I don't love you because you dress nice. I love you because God has put love for his people deep down in my heart, and I just love you. Sincere saints of God. I love God's people. I love this man. And he knows I love him. Because I love men of God. I love them. I mean, I just love men of God. So let us love one another. So what I'm going to do here is very different. We've preached, we've sang, we've prayed, we've shouted and jumped and leaped. But what I'm going to do right now is Monique, I want you to just pull up a song, and I want you to stand to your feet and go find somebody you don't know and just greet them. Say hi to them. And then when you really feel that love in your heart, just look at them and say, you know what? I love you. And may God bless you. And may God keep you. And may God make his face to shine upon you. Lift his countenance upon you, be gracious unto you, and grant you peace in the name of Jesus. Go with God. We will see you again next time.